When the NME Godlike Genius Award was first introduced, it was with very clear guidelines. The recipients not only had to have changed music forever, they must also be as inspirational today as they were in the first flushes of their career. Our 2010 Godlike Genius certainly deserves this award. So much so that when someone first mentioned his name as a possible candidate to me, I couldn't quite believe he hadn't already been given it. Reveal who this award is going to. It's two former godlike genii themselves, Mick and Gillespie.
For the Sex Pistols, the Clash and the Jam. And I love Paul because he took on the quest of living up to the promise of punk rock very seriously. And he wrote some of the most beautiful poetic songs about being young, working class and British. Songs like That's Entertainment, When You're Young, Boy About Town, Dreams of Children, Strange Town, Pretty Green. I could go on all night because he's written so many fucking classics.
Going Underground, Eaton Rituals.
Most people in the music business are cowards. They just want money and fame. But Paul's a true artist, always searching, always real. And in a world full of fakers, phonies and wannabes, he's the real deal.
It's our great pleasure to present this award to this incredible man that we love.
He was like the king, you know.
He can play and he can sing. He can write great tunes, you know what I mean?
He seems to just get better and better.
Just a genius songwriter.
He's just one of the rarities left. Yeah. He's got soul in him.
He's absolutely electric.
There's so many people that Weller has influenced. You can't undervalue that.
I remember seeing him on the Jam doing Eaton Rituals, and it's like, wow.
They inspired devotion, like a football team.
They just sound aggro. They sound like young lads with a point to prove.
It was just the whole sound of the thing. The sort of aggressively played guitar.
When you pick up a guitar and play every chord like it's the last chord that you're ever going to play, you know, that's a rare thing in a band.
You listen to these great pop tunes, you know, you learn the words, you know, you learn the lyrics, and then it blows you away, you know.
The lyrics just clicked with me. They were just fantastic for such a young bloke.
He was writing teenage anthems when he was an actual teenager.
He's got like bad boy style, you know, but he's just really switched on. That's why he's a great frontman, you know.
Yeah, I think every good frontman should have the eyes, and Weller's got the eyes.
I know that his dad managed him and remortgaged the house for the Jam.
He was manager.
Kids come to my going, quality, it's like the Jam, I love the Jam. That's pretty impressive. And what you give
is what you get. If you think he split up the Jam at their height, no one's ever been that cool since, just to go, you know what, that's it, you know, we can't take it any further.
As painful as it was for the fans, I think it was sort of necessary to preserve, you know, Weller's integrity and to give him a new challenge.
He knew how to be sort of quite camp and sort of lightweight, but then the lyrics could be just really quite cutting.
Paul was very stylish, bit of an anorak when it comes to clothes. It's like, oh, the lapel shape is, you know, 2 centimetres, you're not quite right.
I always feel a bit scruffy whenever I see him, actually.
If I get to his age, if I'm still on the planet and I look as cool as him, I'd be pretty proud.
Uh-huh. Oh, yeah. I really envy how prolific Paul is as a songwriter. I wish I could have half the output he does.
He's written some great songs as a solo songwriter.
Of the wild, wild woo. His big album was Stanley Rod because it had all the big hits on. That's when he was at his peak.
When Paul asked me to do Stanley Road, I hadn't done a record cover for some time. I think because he's such a Beatles fan, that's why he wanted me to do it. The ultimate description, of course, is the Mod Father. I mean, he's the ultimate in cool, isn't he, really? Something.
lasted so long because he still looks annoyingly great, you know.
He loves what he does. It's that enthusiasm for his craft which really sets him apart.
People worship at the Temple of Weller, and it's 2010. I think that puts you in iconic status.
He'd hate the word iconic figure, but, you know, he's up there with McCartney in my eyes.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Paul Weller.
Served in the Jam and the Style Council, Weller releases his latest solo album this April. It features collaborations with My Bloody Valentine's Kevin Shields and Jam bassist Bruce Foxton.
What can I say? It's taken us 30 years to realise it, but yes, we got there by the end anyway, yes. I had a fucking top night, and I'm embarrassed anyway because people have said so many nice things about me, but they're all true. And God bless you. Have a good night. Nice one. Thank you very much.
That's it. Paul is making his way around the back to play. All that's left for me to say is thank you very, very much for everybody to come in.
We fucking love you!
Oh, what? Thank you. Thanks to all the performers. All the people who presented awards. All that's left for me to say is, this year, the godlike genius is a mod-like genius. Ladies and gentlemen, lose it big time for Mr. Paul Weller!